When Paige was 5 years old, she come into the living room. Cindy and I were in there. She had this little twirly dress on, like the little girls have out here. And she comes over and she twirls around and says, "Look, Mommy and Daddy, I'm a marrying girl." Yeah. Well, tonight you get to be the marrying girl, finally. And you get to marry the man of your dreams, and we're proud of you.
I cannot believe that the lead custodian, aka the hot janitor I had a crush on, ended up being the love of my life.
There was a teacher that worked at the middle school when I was a custodian there, and I drove the school bus. And she said, "Hey, there's this chick that you should meet. She's really nice and sweet. I think you guys would get along really well and like might hit it off." And then one day I saw her, I was like, "Oh, that must be her." And so I was like, "I'm gonna go clean her classroom."
I just remember being on the phone with my mom. It was my break time. And I was telling her I was super nervous and it was going well. And then Thomas walked into the classroom and I immediately hung up the phone. I said, "Mom, I gotta go, bye."
And I like sat in there for like 45 minutes talking to her.
And he cleaned all the desks, all the chairs, every table in the classroom, the whiteboard. And I thought, man, this is a good janitor. He is cleaning every inch of this room. And I group text my mom and my sister. I said, "The hottest janitor just came in and flirted with me for an hour." And I just remember, no, like, he is so handsome. He's gonna be a firefighter. We really connected.
And I didn't see her for another year.
I ran into him when I was out with some girlfriends. All of his friends were there and they said, "You're the wife. You're the substitute we've been hearing about for the last year and a half."
When I first met Thomas, I wasn't really sold on him. I went over to Paige's house and there were flowers over there from him. And I thought, okay, that's a nice gesture. Then the next week I went over there and there were replacement flowers, even though her first set of flowers hadn't died yet. And I said, okay, this guy's laying it on extra thick, something's fishy. But in the 3 years they've been together, Thomas has continued to replace Paige's flowers week after week. What I love about Thomas is that he is consistent, not just with the flowers, but in his feelings for Paige.
My dearest Paige, I can't begin to express how blessed I feel to start this incredible journey together. The road we've taken may have had a few twists and turns, but in the end, it got us to the right place. Every day that I'm with you, I consider myself so lucky to love and be loved by you. Hey.
First time I've talked to you today.
I know. You're ignoring me.
Are you nervous?
Yes. And it wasn't until now.
Today, the best change happens. I become your wife. I become Mrs. Paige Beard.
Lord, we are so blessed to be here today, to join in your perfect union as man and wife.
On behalf of the Beard and the Ogden families, thank you so much for being out here this afternoon for this beautiful occasion. With this ring, I give myself to you.
I give myself to you.
Receive it as a symbol
of our endless union,
our unbroken love,
and our commitment for this marriage
to glorify God. With this ring, I give myself to you. Receive it as a symbol of our endless union,
our unbroken love,
and our commitment for this marriage
to glorify God.
Thomas, she's all yours.
Throughout all of the life changes we've encountered, one thing has remained the same: your love for me. I will never give up on you or our relationship, even when I want to.
Our wedding day is a day to celebrate you and all the lovely things you are to me. It's on that day when time will stop, as there will no longer be a start or an end. Instead, it's the beginning of forever.
I want to say thank you for coming, and you made our dreams for Paige come true, watching her say to this young man that she loves him, and what an honor. And we thank God for that.
When Thomas started coming around, of course I got to size him up because I got to see, you know, who this guy thinks he's going to take my place. He better be worthy of it. So I started really paying attention. You know, that's I don't pay attention to a lot of details, but when it comes to my girls, I'm watching.
If I had to describe Thomas in one word, that word would be relentless. When he wants something done, he will pursue it to no end. Becoming a firefighter, any of the businesses he does, it's, 100% all the time. And we knew he was relentless about Paige, and I know he will continue to be for their entire marriage.
We were caught up in the light, brought out with the waves, pulled up with the stars, where we always thought we'd stay, young and so alive. Lost inside of love, we conquered, spill out all the dreams in us. We'd offer to never let this whisper get away. Like a treasure, we would always keep it safe. We were caught up in the light, brought out with the waves, pulled up with the stars, where we always thought we'd stay.
I was at Thomas's house, and on his bathroom mirror, there was a list of goals that he had typed out. And this was back in like 2017. And they started out pretty typical: buy a house, get off probation, firefighter probation, not the correctional kind. and save money. The two that stuck out to me the most were treat Paige like a princess every day and pray with Paige every day. Like Thomas's list of goals, Paige had a list of goals of what she wanted in a husband. When I saw Thomas's list, I knew that day that he was everything that she had been praying for.
When I was little, my mom would tell me to pray for my future husband. I prayed every day that God would protect you, prepare you, and guide you towards me. I can finally say that my mom was right. You are a strong leader, and you lead me towards Christ. You made me believe in myself, and you have given me confidence that I've never known before. You are funny, and you push me to see the humor in life, even if I don't want to admit it. I used to say, I want to be a marrying girl, which meant I want to be a girl who gets married. Today, I get to be a marrying girl, and it feels like the best feeling in the world.
So last night, we had asked Thomas, we're like, hey, how did you know that you loved Paige? What was the one moment? And this is what he said. He said they were in LA after she had surprised him with an LA Kings game, and they went to a barbecue spot. Thomas said he looked up and saw Paige was covered in barbecue sauce, and he knew he loved her because she wasn't afraid to get messy while eating barbecue. We knew they'd ultimately end up together. So here's your lifetime of happiness and love to Thomas and Paige. Cheers.
It's been a privilege to watch you grow from this sweet little girl to a lovely young lady. And I'll always cherish our daddy-daughter dances and our daddy-daughter dates, Paige, and I hope we can continue to do them. So, Thomas, tonight we give you our best and we give you God's best. She's everything you could have dreamed of, and I think you know it. Paige, Thomas, may God bless your marriage. May God bless your family. May God bless the work you do. And most importantly, may God bless the ministries that you get involved with. Thank you, guys.